It is great to see the room full. Welcome to all of you. As I've said to several people, my theory is the main reason more people came today is because of the part of the schedule that says Bucky and ice cream. But for whatever reasons you came, we're delighted that you're here. I'm delighted to welcome you to the University of Wisconsin here in Madison and to the 2017 Business Engagement Day. We've been doing these every other year now for a number of years, and they've really been successful. Special thanks to Susan LaBelle and to her team at the Office of Corporate Relations for all of their work in setting up the day. As Susan noted, one of the things I have been focused on during my time here as Chancellor is on focusing on trying to build the relationships between the university and the business community. And I'm going to tell you more in a moment about some of the partnerships that we're creating. And I hope that as you go through this day, that you're going to think about your own ideas and your own ways in which you can interact with the university, or if you have some great ideas about ways in which we can be helpful to you and interact with you that we're not doing, feed them to Susan or feed them to some of the members of our corporate relations team, because we are always looking for good ideas. Let me begin by sharing a brief story about a company that was part of our 2015 open house. East Bay Foot Locker, a company many of you know about, is headquartered in Wausau. They employ about 3,000 people, and like many of you, they're very focused on talent hiring, retention, and development. I had toured their facility, and when I heard about what they were working on, I asked them to come to this event 2 years ago. When they were here, they talked with career services people from the College of Letters and Sciences. They visited with athletics to discuss internships, and they stopped by the professional development and executive education booth to learn more about the 67 different professional masters and capstone certificates that we offer and that members of their staff can participate in. That one day really changed the way in which East Bay and Foot Locker recruits at UW and interacts with us. They now work regularly with career services to review student resumes. They provide guest speakers for classes. They participate in a variety of our career fairs. And they're even looking at using UW students as models in some of their catalogs. We're very photogenic here. We hear stories like that again and again. And it's why the day on campus has become one of our most popular business events. This year, we have a record number of participants. We're in a bigger and different room because we couldn't fit where we were before. We've got folks here from Illinois, Minnesota, Pennsylvania, and of course, across the great state of Wisconsin. I know that many of you are not on campus regularly, and for some of you, this may be your first visit here to UW-Madison. So I want to just say a few words about some of the good things that are happening here. We've had a really successful year and are looking into launching another one. Next week, we are going to welcome the largest freshman class in our history, about 6,600 students who are chosen from among a record-breaking 35,000 applications. They're coming from across Wisconsin, from 42 U.S. states, and 46 countries outside the U.S. Our time to graduation has been falling steadily for a number of years, and that means students are able to graduate on time and with less debt. More than half of our students finish their degree without any debt whatsoever. And that number has also climbed over time, and we're at one of the highest points we've been in the last 10 to 15 years. On the research front, we are not just a great educational institution, we're also a wonderful place for faculty to do groundbreaking research that is read and commented on and used not just around Wisconsin and around the nation, but around the world. Last month, our researchers who work on developing alternative energy sources landed one of the largest federal grants in our history from the U.S. Department of Energy, a grant that is going to continue to guarantee that we remain a national hub for energy research. So on both the research and the education side, it's just a really lively place to be and a fun place to be to hear what's going on across campus. Of course, our research partnerships with business are the ways in which we a very crucial way in which we interact with the world around us, not only because this is where our students go after they graduate, but also because this is the point for much of the research that we do. How does it get out there and get used in useful ways in the business community, in industry of all sorts around the nation? Much of that research is done in partnership with Wisconsin farmers or with local and regional businesses. And research partnerships with companies across the region is just, it's a key focus, I say, not only of what I'm working on, but what a lot of people across the university are working on. We can always do that better. And again, we're always looking for ideas about how we do it better. Industry-university partnerships are win-win. Industry supports our research in an area of interest and then pulls out the ideas that are of particular relevance and are promising applications for their own work. Many companies, many industries are cutting back on internal R&D over the last decade, and collaborative work with universities like UW-Madison is becoming critically important for those industries and for individual companies to stay at the cutting edge of innovation. GE Healthcare, for example, is working with us on a state-of-the-art imaging research center that's changing the way in which cancer is diagnosed and treated. Land's End is creating a data center that our students are largely going to staff using the big data they have in terms of sales and outreach to allow our students to analyze customer and sales data that will in turn help Land's End solve some of their high-value problems. And I know we have people here today from both of those companies and many others who are working on other collaborations with us. That's the kind of innovative thinking that's going to drive business development and keep both this university and our business partners moving forward. Another key way in which UW-Madison works with business, of course, is serving as a talent pipeline. We graduate more and more highly educated students than any other institution in this state. Problems in hiring workers with the right skills is the biggest complaint that I often hear when I go out and talk to businesses. Our undergraduates have high test scores and high academic ability, but as many of you know, that's usually not all that you want. You also want people who know how to engage outside the classroom. And one of the real things we've been working on here on the educational front is adding to the in-classroom experience, making sure that students understand how important it is not just to do well in their classes, but to think consciously about what are the outside the classroom experiences that they want to acquire and learn from. Things like community service, leadership and student organizations, internships and other forms of work experience, or study abroad and other types of travel and global engagement. We're trying to push all students to engage in some number of those type of high impact practices that really give them the community and the world engagement skills beyond what they learn inside classrooms. And I might note, beyond our undergraduates and their work, our graduate students, who do tend to spend a lot of time in classrooms and not look up from that while they're doing it, when they do graduate, are among some of our most skilled, particularly in the research and sciences areas where a lot of businesses in this region hire as well. Beyond providing a skilled workforce, we're also committed to developing a workforce that reflects the diversity of the society around us. And let's face it, this region, this state, is a very white and non-diverse state compared to some other parts of the country and the world. And we want our graduates, particularly those who come from the upper Midwest, when they come to this university, to have the experience of working in much more diverse communities and to be ready when they leave to live with, to work with, to be friends and colleagues with, people who have very different backgrounds from their own. That's a challenge. That's a challenge to all institutions, but it's a particular challenge to us here in the upper Midwest. And you know, for a lot of students who come here to UW-Madison, this is by far the most diverse place they have ever seen. And that's an important part of their learning as well. When all of these students graduate, they want to find the right job. And that's where we hope we can be good partners with all of you. When we first launched this event in 2012, we looked around the country for model programs that we could build it on. And we're sure that someone somewhere had pulled together sort of this type of event with a range of campus resources and bringing the business community in that you know, really built business campus relationships. But to the surprise of those who went looking for that model, they couldn't find it. So with a lot of help and support from many companies and groups here in the room, we instead built the national model. More than a dozen universities around the country have asked to come here so we can show them how they do it on their campus. We have 11 different schools and colleges represented today, along with research centers and institutes from across the campus. And every one of them is eager to talk to you and to figure out how to work together. I hope when you leave here, you got some new ideas and potentially some better solutions about how to deal with some of the problems that your industry, your business is facing. And I want to mention that while this event is only today, the Office of Corporate Relations is there and available and answers their phone pretty much every day to help you make connections across campus when you want to think about how do we hire more effectively, how do we get in touch with researchers or students or faculty who are working on a particular problem. So don't hesitate to pick up the phone and call Susan LaBelle or any of her colleagues. So thank you all for being here today. I hope you have a great day. I unfortunately cannot stick around, but I can tell you your keynote speaker, Tom Falk, is really going to be wonderful. He's someone who I just have enormous respect and liking for, one of our alums, and I hope you're all going to stay for his keynote address because that's going to be worth staying for. So thank you for coming. Enjoy the day, and on Wisconsin.